organization. I think he had at most a 5 million advertising budget, and he was in jail. And he won. And on a local gubernatorial level, this happened several times. Because people, the basic reason why it's happening is that people are sick and tired of traditional politics. They don't want to vote between lesser and greater evil. They want real choices in the 2010 elections. And they've been waiting for this for a long time. And so that national desire, many Filipinos, backed up by media, internet, leveraging, projecting this desire, can also lead to a very credible national campaign. That's why it's going to be like that. That's why all of a sudden you don't see, and then all of a sudden you see. My own estimation is that February, March, okay, I think we should start watching what happens in March. If people begin to see that I climbed up to 5% in a credible survey, then you begin to see a real, I think people will really get scared. Because starting from zero to 0.03% to 0.1% to, no. But for me, because I understand that you don't create Rome in a day, you don't create a presence in one day, you just really create it through the hard process of educating people, which is facilitated by the internet and the media and direct conversations with their leaders, political leaders. So that's why I'm saying the April surveys will be the more decisive for me.
Since we're talking about money and funding already, yes. I hope it's okay if you disclose.
Yes, sure.
Like you said, Rianis had 5 million for advertising,
that's
alone. Yeah. And your opponent, like I said earlier, said around 30 million to waste a national campaign. Yeah. How much is your fund, more or less, for this?
My own personal fund for this is 2 million.
And where do you get
it? 2 million for my own funds.
Mm-hmm.
And I've spent over 1 million already in that. And there are donations that are coming in from individuals here and abroad. You know, 100 pesos, $5. But this is it, right? And then increasingly, for the first time, I won't mention names, we received a donation. Somebody's donating a whole piece of land for us to sell. And all the proceeds will go to us. I mean, this is what I'm saying, because you cannot predict how people will express their love for this country. We are fighting for the survival of the future of the country. And if people don't feel that, you know, then we're really lost as a nation. But if people start to feel that, then material possessions become secondary, they're willing to donate. In that connection, I'm going to reserve a massive announcement in a few weeks. And of course, I'm going to announce it's through Blood Watch.
Yes.
Just to,
very nice.
In connection with resources. This is totally not happened in the whole history of Philippine politics. It's a kind of surprise. It's really huge. Not only monetarily large, but the way where the source of the money is coming from is so unusual and so impossible that people will say, what the hell is going on? And that's why I don't want to announce it yet until it's in black and white. But you can be sure that this model which I stated is not an abstraction, because we are experiencing it daily in our lives. I mean, for example, our volunteers alone, some of them are already sleeping in the headquarters, but they're full-time professionals. You can imagine if you started to pay for their salaries. I mean, each one of them probably you have to pay half a million or more. Some of them are even, and I mean, there's a lot of, how do you calculate volunteer time? This is what I was saying to Pomelec. You cannot just count stack of money that's there. How can you calculate the passion of a person? The ideals, the sense of meaning and purpose of a person. You cannot calculate a spiritual force, because that's what's going to happen. It's a moral spiritual force. is going to surface and is surfacing in this election because I think people are really sensing 2010, if nothing really dramatic happens here, it will be like traditional parties as usual. We're going to see basically the death of this nation.
It's off topic now for the life.
Please.
Now that you will be endorsed by Zoe Ayala, who is a musician composer, do you see yourself having your own jingle one of these days? Like,
isn't he donating a song?
Yeah.
Will you be having your
which
own
one?
Yeah, Joey actually offered to do a jingle.
A new one.
Just for our campaign. Actually, a number of artists have offered to do it. One of the other things is starting to happen. I don't know why, but I think the artistic community is starting to wake up. There's an increasing number of artists, writers, and so on who are coming in because they sense that this campaign has a very deep understanding of the creativity of the, not only the human process, but the artistic process, but the actual unusual creativity that it will take to win this election as well as to run this country. We cannot rely on tired old formulas from the past to move this country forward. We have to rely on really innovative, creative means to bring this country forward. And the Philippines is one of the most creative countries in the world. I totally know that from experience among friends here and abroad. And this is why it pains me to have a decadent political system sitting on top of all this talent that cannot express itself. And this is what I want to free up. This is the talent I want to free up in this country that has been oppressed for so long. This is it. And that's why I think we owe it to ourselves to really say, this is the moment of liberation. We have to act on our highest motives. And then if people started doing that, then these higher motives will win. And can you imagine a country run on the highest motives, not on the lowest denominator of one compromise after another, which destroying the soul of the soul? That's why I feel that this is possible in this country. And if we really do this for this country, we will also have quite a global impact in what we will be able to contribute to the world. And I want to turn around the image that Filipinos are nothing but corrupt people, drug addicts, traffickers, prostitutes. That's not the Filipino. This is the exploited Filipino because the political system does not really care for the Filipino. And this is why, for me, this has to stop. And that's why it's not easy for a civil society person to be in the middle of politics, especially at the presidential level. And it's very inconvenient that I felt that I had to do it because that voice had to be there. And it's really up for the Filipino people to respond if they really want to see this country turn a new leaf, a very different country that we can all be proud of, and rightfully so.
Okay. We've invited guest bloggers here who are also supporters of Nick Perlas. So it's your turn to ask a question. If you have a question to ask, come over here lang. Yeah, sige na.
Yeah,
not
just a
drink.
There's something really funny.
Okay. Next, we would like to mention that.